What's up, guys? Today we are testing another mini PC, but unlike some previous computers we have had that run on Intel processors, this one has a really good Ryzen 7 5700U processor. It is positioned as a small gaming PC. We will definitely play some games on it. We also have a version with 32 gigs of RAM and 1 TB of SSD. You know, I like the ACEMAGIC brand, and I have been using their mini PC for over a year now. However, they have a tarnished reputation because some of their computers had pre-installed viruses. We will also check this mini PC for malware, but let's start with the unboxing and design. On the box we can see an image of the mini PC in gray and black. My computer is black in color. There's also an ACEMAGIC logo on the front. You know, my main computer is called ACEMAGIC. To be honest, I don't know what the difference is, but it seems like the same brand. There is a product information on the back of the box. As I already said, I have a version with 32 gigs of RAM and 1 TB of storage. But you can also choose from many other options, including barebone with no RAM and ROM. Opening the box, we see the user manual in different languages. Then we have a mini PC in factory packaging. Let's take it off. But we will take a closer look at the computer a little later. The package also includes an HDMI cable, power supply, and a VESA bracket. Talking about design of the ACEMAGIC K1 mini PC, it looks much simpler than my main computer. However, I know that many people didn't like the design of this computer, so maybe it is a good thing that the ACEMAGIC K1 looks like this. In addition, the new mini PC takes up much less space on the desk. Its dimensions are 127x127x42mm. The weight is 405 grams. It only has ACEMAGIC logo on top. The front panel of the mini PC has USB Type-C port, two USB 3.2 Gen 2 ports, 3.5mm audio jack, and power button. You know, I was very surprised to see 4 more USB-E ports on the back panel, even though they are USB 3.2 Gen 1. There is also LAN port, DP port, HDMI 2.0 port, and a DC input on the back of the mini PC. The ACEMAGIC K1 has an enhanced cooling system with high-speed fan and a dual exhaust design. We will check the computer temperature and fan noise a little later. Let's try to take the case apart and look at the fan and what else is inside. To do this, we need to remove the rubber fit at the bottom, and here we find 4 bolts that should be unscrewed. Now we get access to the board, fan and the rest. But I am most interested in RAM and ROM. Since I have the 32GB RAM version of the mini PC, it has 2 16GB RAM drives. You can replace them with 2 32GB drives because the computer supports up to 64GB RAM total. As for the SSD, it is 1 TB M.2.2280 SATA drive from NATEC. We will check its read and write speed a little later in this video. Okay, let's put the mini PC back together and finally turn it on. In fact, I have already turned it on to install programs and games, but we need to check out the boot speed anyway. So the ACEMAGIC K1 mini PC started up in just 29 seconds. I will just remind you that my previous ACEMAGIC mini PC with a more powerful Ryzen 9 6900HX processor started up in 16 seconds. That computer boots much faster, and I think it is because of the better SSD. Before we move on to the software and performance testing, I have to scan the mini PC for viruses. I will be using the malware bytes for this, but I think any antivirus will detect viruses. Unfortunately, the malware was detected. You know, I was hoping that only a small batch of the older ACEMAGIC computers had viruses. But this mini PC is a new 2025, and it also has malware. Of course, there is a solution to this – reinstall Windows, but it will take some time and effort. This really upset me. But let's continue the review. I will reinstall Windows later to remove the malware, but for now, let's talk about the installed operating system. The ACEMAGIC K1 mini PC runs on Windows 11 Pro. I would like to say it is a clean system, but since it has viruses, that's not really true. However, there is a Microsoft Store, Microsoft 365 Copilot, and other programs from Microsoft. If we talk about hardware, we can see that the mini PC has a single drive with a capacity of 952 GB. I have most of the storage already taken up by programs and games. I have said before that there is an SSD installed here from NATO company. Let's check its speed right away. Unfortunately, the read and write speeds are very slow, 530 and 100 megabits per second. You know, the disk speed affects a computer's overall performance, especially when it comes to boot time, application loading, and gaming. I would advise you to change it to something better that has at least 1000 megabit per second, and ideally over 3000 megabits per second like the previous ACEMAGIC computer we tested. As for the RAM, I have two 16GB drives installed, so the total is 32GB. That's enough for me, but mini PC supports up to 64GB, so you can replace them with two 32GB drives. When it comes to the processor, the ACEMAGIC K1 mini PC is equipped with the AMD Ryzen 7 5700U processor with integrated AMD Radeon RX Vega 8 graphics. You know, it is not a new processor, because it was released back in 2021, but it has quite good scores on the CPU benchmarks website, such as 15669 multi-thread and 2564 single-thread. In addition, this processor has only 25 watts maximum TDP, while the typical TDP is 15 watts. When I run the stress test, the TDP goes even higher, up to 31 watts. But levels off to 25 watts after a while. We can also see the CPU temperature here. By the way, let's also measure the noise level of the mini PC. Right now, the computer is in standby mode, and the processor is only 10% loaded. The fan doesn't seem to be running at all, because the mini PC is silent, only 39 decibels. We can run the stress test and see that the CPU is loaded at 100%. I can hear the fan noise, but the mini PC is still pretty quiet, 42 decibels. Quiet operation and low power consumption are the main features of any mini PC, including the ACEMAGIC K1. Since we have already started talking about the processor, let's run some benchmark tests. The ACEMAGIC K1 mini PC has 16-18 points in a single core test and 72-74 points in a multi-core test of the Geekbench 6 benchmark. In the Cinebench R23 benchmark, we also have a single core and multi-core result 7760 and 1193 respectively. The next benchmark is called Passmark Performance Test. In addition to the CPU mark, there is also 2D mark, 3D mark, memory mark, and disk mark. The last benchmark to test processor performance is PC mark. It is my favorite because it has a graph with comparison to other computers. So the ACEMAGIC K1 has 50-46 overall score, and this result is lower than an office laptop. We should also check the graphics performance of this computer since it is positioned for gaming. 3D mark will help us with that. It is recommended to run the Fire Strike test, so let's do that. The overall score in this benchmark is 37-12, which is above average. I also want to run the Time Spy test. The overall score here is 14-89 points, and it is also above average. Finally, we get to the most important part of our review, the games. Once again, let me remind you that the ACEMAGIC K1 is positioned as a mini gaming PC. So I have installed the following games: Dota 2, PUBG Battlegrounds, Counter-Strike 2, Cyberpunk 2077, and Spider-Man 2. Let's start with the simple but popular games and move on to the more demanding ones. In a way, I like to watch gameplay videos without commentary, so I suggest you do that now, and then I will tell you what I think about the gaming performance of this mini PC.
Very funny. This is a prank. Not in the mood, if so.
It's anything but. You must have questions, and I'll answer them in due course, shortly. But first, I need you to get to that swollen appendix in Night City called Dogtown.
Fine. No clue what I'm stepping into, but blind.
Get lost. What you got in the back?
So the good news is that you can play all these games on the ACEMAGIC K1 mini PC. We can already call it a gaming mini PC, right? However, you need to choose 720p resolution to play Counter-Strike and Spider-Man comfortably. The graphics in the last game are really bad. It is a really demanding game, though, and I am glad it runs on this budget mini PC. You probably will not only play games on this computer, so let's check out some office and home tasks on it. First, let's try adding 4K video in Adobe Premiere Pro As you can see, no problems with it, scrolling on the timeline. As for the export time, it takes only 39 seconds to save 1 minute of a 4K video. Now let's play 4K video on YouTube in Google Chrome browser. No problems with that. The videos play very smoothly without any lags. As for multitasking, I have 10 tabs open in a browser with our videos. I can switch between tabs and play every video. That's very good. By the way, if you get any delay in the browser, you may have slow internet connection. The ACEMAGIC K1 mini PC supports dual-band Wi-Fi 6. My service provider gives me a 100 megabits per second connection, and the download and upload speeds are even higher on this mini PC. That's great! You can also use 1000 megabits per second LAN port for wired internet connection. Of course, you can use the ACEMAGIC K1 mini PC for office tasks. It has Microsoft 365 pre-installed with Word, Excel, PowerPoint and other apps. So we have tested the new ACEMAGIC K1 mini PC, and I'm ready to give you my verdict about it. Let's start with what I didn't like. First, I really didn't like the viruses on this computer. I had hope that only some ACEMAGIC computers had viruses before, and that this problem had been solved. But no, even the new ACEMAGIC K1 mini PC has malware, and you have to reinstall Windows to get rid of it. Another big problem with this mini PC is a slow SSD. Yes, it has nice 1TB capacity, but the read speed is only 500 Mbps per second. That's very slow. I recommend you install a faster SSD right away. Although the mini PC has a pretty old processor from 2021, it has quite good performance. The benchmark results are really good for a mini PC in this price range. And you can even play heavy games like Cyberpunk 2077. In general, the real problems of this mini PC can be solved, such as removing viruses and installing a faster SSD. After that, you will get a good mini PC for gaming, office, and home tasks. Thank you for watching. See you soon!